Well, good evening, this is Hound Dog Steve coming to you on the 28th of October, which is a Sunday evening. And seeing as things have calmed down, the election is over now, and things are sort of slowly receding back to normal. Anyway, I thought I'd pick up some of the more amusing pieces of entertainment, shall we say. Anyway, I was looking around for some of those things that make you say, only in America. So my first story is underwater pumpkin carving. And here they are, all at the bottom of the ocean. And they've got the pumpkins, and they're carving away. And the first prize is, of course, what would you expect? A dive trip. This one I particularly like. Woman sues bed maker after being catapulted from a bed during sex. Busby told a British court that she was kneeling in the middle of the bed performing a sex act when she shifted and swung her legs from underneath her. How do you do that? That was when the bed gave way and she was thrown off the end, landing on her head. I spun around, I put my hand down, and felt like I was catapulted off the back of the bed, she testified. My head hit the floor, and I fell to the side, and then I heard like a spring in my body snap, it felt like. Judge Barry Cotter said the central issue is whether or not there were defects in the bed. Well, how embarrassing to have to explain your private sexual preferences to a British judge. Eating squirrel brains nuts. Doc. What can I say? We don't recommend the squirrel brains. A 61-year-old backwards Gorman died after he developed a deadly brain disease from eating squirrel brains. The New York man was taken to Rochester Hospital in 2015 complaining that he was having trouble thinking, losing touch with reality, and couldn't walk. Doctors diagnosed the unnamed man with a degenerative disease caused by the same infection proteins that cause mad cow disease, the Daily Mail reports. And this: English is a foreign language in England. And I'm going to just play the clip because it is extremely funny. Britain's Parliament was divided by a common language on Thursday, as one politician was forced to repeat a question twice when his colleague couldn't understand him before eventually submitting the question in writing after his attempts at verbal communication failed. Both politicians, of course, were speaking English. The incident took place during a meeting about House of Commons commissions, a body that oversees the administration of Parliament and its grounds, as David Linden of the Scottish National Party asked Conservative Member of Parliament Paul Beresford about planned renovation works. The two politicians represent constituencies in Britain that are roughly 350 miles apart. That's like about that far in Canada. Only a little further apart than Los Angeles and San Francisco, and closer together than DC and Boston. But Beresford, who represents Mole Valley in Surrey, England, could not understand the accent of Linden, who represents Glasgow East in Scotland. Despite being a relatively small country, Britain has a vast array of different regional accents. Anyway, take a look at this clip and see if you can understand what Mr. Linden is saying.
Much, Mr. Speaker, I know from speaking to a number of parliamentary colleagues that there are still certain aspects of the estate, including the Northern Estate, that are not great for people with disabilities. Can I ask the Honourable Gentleman what work is being done to make sure that this place is more accessible, particularly for some of our colleagues who have a disability?
Hear, hear.
I'm sorry, it must be something to do with my Antipodean background. Could he please repeat the question, because I didn't follow it?
Well, very popular today. I'm saying that a number of parliamentary colleagues who have disabilities do find it quite difficult getting around certain parts of the estate. Given that we're doing this refurbishment work, what can be done to make sure that those with a disability are able to move around more freely and the place is accessible?
I'm really sorry. Please, could you do it very slowly and intimidate in English? Thank you.
Just give me any old answer.
I think the answer might be helped if you can reply in writing when you read. Right, Chris.
And it is, of course, interesting in England. There are so many accents, and you really don't have to move as far as 350 miles. You can actually go, maybe 30 miles, and you can start to notice regional differences in the accent. And Marilyn Manson, what a money-making hound Marilyn Manson is. selling a dildo with his face on it. Can you imagine? You can buy them from his website for $125. A listing promoting the bizarre merchandise reassures potential customers that the paint used to put Manson's likeness on the end of the sex aid is environmentally safe, but warns the beautiful people musician's visage may fade with use. The 49-year-old has wasted no time in promoting his unusual new venture, suggesting there may be an ideal Halloween gift in a post on Instagram. Next to a picture of the dildo's listing on his site, he wrote, "I guess this is Halloween D-I-C-K or treat." Very funny, Marilyn Manson. Well, it's a crazy old wacky world out there, and you have just got to laugh, don't you? Because if you don't laugh, you would cry. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed those few little items, and this is Hound Dog Steve signing off, and we will talk to you very soon. You take care now. Stay safe. See you soon.